Carrie Engle is here from Valley View Farms. Hi, Carrie.
Hey, Lisa.
Well, this is a beauty and a wonderful gift, right?
This is great. This is Phalaenopsis. It's one of the easiest orchids to grow. We just have it sitting in another orchid pot, but they just grow and bark, water them when they're dry to the touch. They really are almost foolproof, believe it or not. People are afraid of orchids, but they really are pretty easy to grow.
You don't do anything.
They don't do anything.
Yeah, I forget about them, and I water them maybe like every 2 weeks.
That's true.
All right, our producer, Ken Stokes, Grandma Hart, wants to know what this is.
I'm not positive, but I think it's a pineapple. And just a couple of things. It's in a pot that has no drainage, and it's really, really wet. So you might think about repotting this into a pot that does have some drainage, and it has a little bit of a nutrient deficiency. Get it some fertilizer that has a lot of trace elements in it. Miracle-Gro would be fine, but anything that has a lot of trace elements in it, and that'll help get it back to a darker green color.
It's going to be a pineapple?
I think so. It has a serrated leaf like a pineapple. Yeah, I mean, to get it to grow a pineapple, what we'd have to do is put an apple or some kind of fruit just in with a big bag, and the apple will give off ethylene gas, and that should promote some bloom from the center of this and eventually get you a pineapple.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a lot of work. Okay. Let's get to some of our other questions. What types of bulbs should be planted in the fall, winter?
A lot of things can be planted now that the soil's finally cooled down a good bit. You can go ahead and still plant daffodils, crocus, hyacinths, tulips. They can all go in now. And it's a great time to do it because the soil is down to like 40-some degrees now, mm-hmm. whereas before when we tend to plant them September, October, the soil's still a little too warm. So now's a great time to do it.
You just throw them in? I mean, don't they kind of move around? Or
they do a little bit, but I mean, most of them put down like 3 or 4 times their diameter deep. So a daffodil can go to like 6 inches down, same with tulips. The hyacinths and things that are much smaller bulbs, maybe just a couple of inches down. Right. Watch out for some varmints. They don't bother plants in the onion family like all the alliums, and they don't mess with daffodils because they're toxic.
Okay, all right. What is the best way to deal with shrubs that are covered with ice or snow? No, don't say that. We don't have any of that yet.
I know, I saw a snow plow. I'm like, wait a minute. The best way is kind of just leave them be. If you have one that really like splays open, I guess, you can tie the center branches together. I tend not to cover them in burlap or anything, kind of just let them do what they do. If you have a plant that goes through a lot of winter burn, if you spray them what they call an anti-desiccant, I think we carry one called Wilt Proof, it sort of locks the moisture in so it doesn't dry out too much, and that certainly helps when you had windy, cold weather.
All right, thanks, Carrie.
Thank you, Lisa.
Up next.